If you have felt the call from the realm beyond of the goddess Ceridwen to seek what may be next for you, or answers to the question you might have, take a moment to bask in the knowledge that the universe has done everything within its power to bring you here to this exact moment. Allow your guard to begin to drop as you settle into your meditative space. Allowing your head to become heavy, whether you allow it to lull forward or to be cradled by a pillow. Notice how your jaw becomes slack. Your teeth are no longer clenched. And you can feel the pull of the cool night air on your tongue as it enters your lungs. You pause for just a heartbeat, then exhale, lowering back into yourself. Feel your lungs become comfortably full. Listen to the sound of your heartbeat, then exhale, letting the warm air leave your lips. Inhale, notice your stomach becoming round and full, and at the peak of its capacity, allow yourself to deflate as you sink deeper and deeper within yourself. Feel the weight of your limbs as they have become impossibly heavy, rooting you in the space, grounding your physical body like an anchor to this physical realm. Notice the silence within your mind as your attention remains focused on simply what you are feeling in this moment. As you lay upon your mattress, your spiritual self begins to flourish underneath your skin. Eager to be in tune with the powers all around you. Allow your walls to finally drop as you exist in this state. Relaxed, calm, your mind quiet and clear. And focus all of your energy into asking the universe for an answer on a single question. Repeat it silently to yourself like a mantra. Tandem with your breathing. Over until all of the words begin to melt and blend together. This watercolor effect washes over your body. Allowing your higher self, your more divine self, to finally break free of the barrier of your skin. Slipping out, looking down upon yourself as you still breathe evenly and calm. You notice the subtle change in the air all around. A door has appeared before you. Notice all of its details, where its golden knob is, how ivy and plants wildly grow from it. Or even the unique carvings and symbols upon the wood. Add more and more detail with each breath as you ground yourself in this moment. Breathe in, seeing a gentle light reach through the cracks of the door. Breathe out. Breathe in. Know that you can always return by following your breath. Breathe out. Breathe in. Notice the texture underneath your fingertips as you push the portal open. Breathe out. And bathe in the light that floods your space. As you slowly drift through the portal, allow yourself to be guided from this world to the next. You recognize where you're going in the depths of your soul, perhaps from this life or the next. You know that you are safe here, being guided by those on the other side who wish to assist and help you through whatever it is that you are facing. And allow the magic of the world around you to transport you from your bedroom away. Thank you. beneath your feet. The earth is soft and damp, squishing between your toes. Your lips are met with warm air, heavy with humidity. Your ears are filled with the song of frogs singing and chirping to the nighttime sky. Your eyes slowly flutter open, and you are met with the sight, surrounded by a wash of crystal stars, a brilliant black moon hanging in the sky before you. The stars' silver light bathing everything in a milky glow. Before you, a perfectly tranquil lake reflects the beauty of the heavens. You can see an ocean of evergreen trees surrounding the clearing. Their wide, powerful branches reaching upwards into the sky. And on the far side of the pond, nestled among flowers, unique rock formations, is a small, cozy cottage. Emitting a warm glow from small round windows, promising the flames of a hearth. You take a moment to steady yourself, focusing your mind, bringing your powerful, magical intuition forward. Feeling warm, flood your form. As you can feel your desires swell and take form, leaving you in incantation for what it is that you are seeking from this realm. You can feel a visible weight release from your celestial form, dissipating into the unseen magic all around you. And you can sense down to your very bones that something has shifted within the universe. Your feet have already begun to carry you alongside the shore, allowing the shallow waves to lap over your toes and ankles. Fireflies flitter along the glassy surface, almost seeming to guide you to the mythical cottage of the goddess. As you draw closer, the warm orange glow grows in size, almost seeming to silently welcome you, embracing you in its light. Warmth fills you from this glow. Relaxing your muscles, making you feel safe, knowing that the goddess is watching you, guiding you to whatever it may be that you are supposed to see. You pass by a flourishing vegetable garden filled with crops and fruits. Their leaves large and dark, brimming with life, seeming to grow with an almost unnatural sense of beauty. A large white sow shuffles through the ground, its snuffling nose to the earth, its pale skin glowing in the starlight. You can sense power radiating from the creature, and you know that this pig is sacred to the goddess. It slowly lifts its head, the sow's brown gaze meeting yours. You recognize intelligence insight and a sparkle of wisdom within the sacred animal's eyes, and you can sense the message this white boar has for you. Warmth suddenly bubbles from the very center of your chest, overflowing and rushing over your skin, seeping into you. Renewed strength floods your bones. Your very essence feels healed, inspired for whatever might be ahead. Without thinking, you dip your head in a respectful nod to the sow, who watches you carefully, her eyes never leaving yours, as she slowly tilts her massive head downward until her snout gently brushes the rich, damp earth. A single heartbeat passes, and the familiar of Ceridwen slowly turns, letting out small grunts and grumbles, as if it were thinking out loud. Until it disappeared into the thick, well-tended foliage that surrounds the cottage. You take a moment to steady yourself, breathing in slowly and steadily, allowing yourself to take in the view of the sanctuary all around you, absorbing everything you have experienced so far. Breathe in and allow your lungs to fill with the warm summer air. You allow your arms to stretch out at your sides, as if you are embracing the world around you. Breathe out. Breathe in and allow your eyes to scan over the still lake, seeing the countless stars reflect from above, moving to the dense tree line. You watch yellow, slowly blinking fireflies flitter through the surrounding underbrush. Breathe out. Breathe in and turn to finally face the glowing cabin right before you. Breathe out. Add details to this cottage with each passing breath. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Notice the entryway, seeing the shapes and designs on the door, counting how many windows there may be. And perhaps noticing any blooming flowers that greet you. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Allow a single hand to stretch outward, your fingertips gently brushing the door. Immediately, you are flooded with the sense of raw, untamed magic coursing throughout you. You are almost knocked back by the intensity. Yet despite this, you are not afraid of what lies before you. In fact, you are calm, cool, and collected. With a loud creak, the doorway swings open by no means of your own. Respectfully, you bow your head once again in a polite nod. A thank you to whatever powers are ushering you forward. You pass through the entryway, feeling the unseen veil, the protective barrier, wash over you. You peer around the cottage, surprised at how large it seems from the inside. At the far wall, right across from you, a large fire roars. Smoke billows up to the large chimney. The orange glow casts long shadows all around you that dance on the smooth wooden floors beneath your feet. Next to you, a large oak desk is covered with tiny, intricate carvings. Upon it, books, papers, and ink are strewn about, almost completely covering the table. Like a moth to a flame, you are drawn to a handwritten note, a small poem that seems to call out to you. Follow your intuition and read upon the words Ceridwen has written. You roll the word over your tongue, feeling the power and the magic the goddess has embedded into this chant. The energies leave your lips as you speak, filling the space around you as you practice refining and understanding the words. And you know that within this moment, as the pages of the open books all around you begin to flutter and tremble in an unseen gale, that these words have conjured a spell, an incantation just for you. Your words come to a slow, and the swirling enchantment begin to dissipate, lazily swirling all around your form until they disappear completely. You stand in silence, only hearing the crackling of a fireplace as you take in what you have just witnessed. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Still clutching the note to your chest, your feet begin to carry you. Away from the chaos of the desk, past a cozy, cluttered kitchen. The warm smell of fresh rosemary bread drifts from a small iron oven. Around filled bookshelves, brimming with tomes that perhaps date time itself, their golden texts beginning to shimmer as you pass, until you come face to face with an overstuffed hutch. Its countless glass cabinets filled with unique trinkets, crystals of all shapes and sizes, some glowing and shimmering. Dried herbs and pressed flowers of all colors populate the shelf. vials of unique and rare powders or liquids are lined neatly on the desk. Even some bones of animals that you do not recognize are tucked away within the drawers. You allow your eyes to scan over the gigantic freestanding cabinet, noticing everything hidden and tucked away among the curiosities. Until one item in particular seems to begin to glow, firmly standing out among all the others. It seems to call to you, singing a silent tune as you realize that the goddess has brought you face to face with your focus. It could be anything from the bones of a dragon to a crystal from another realm, or even a handcrafted wand made by Ceridwen herself. Whatever it may be, this object is one that you may use to amplify your inner magic, empowering you in your spell casting. You clutch the item within your hand, rolling it over your fingers, noticing its weight, shape, and texture, feeling it seeming to vibrate with anticipation. You whisper soft words to the item, perhaps the incantation from before, or even a simple spell you use in your day-to-day life. Watch the item respond to your voice and your energy as you become attuned to it. The fire bellows, growing in size, demanding your attention as you turn to face it. As the hot orange blaze begins to die down from the sudden burst, you realize that from within the hearth, a large black cauldron stands proudly and resiliently as the flame once again begin to lick the bottom of the iron pot. The contents within begin to loudly broil. Bubbles and steam rising from its open face. You approach the fires, unafraid, confident and comfortable, knowing that you were meant to be here in this moment. You peer into the cauldron, watching the glittering, silky liquid broil and bubble. Causing steam to rise wildly, the splashes and movement of the waters are almost enchanting. And you cannot bring yourself to look away. Your focus begins to glow within your hands, almost in tune with the molten creation right before you. And with your next breath, color begins to flood the cauldron. Like a drop of food coloring in crystal water, your own magic begins to become infused with the potion before you. Adding your own flair, your signature to the creation, you clutch your mythical object within your fingers, feeling warmth rise from it. As you squeeze, your eyes shut. Willing the words, the poetry that the goddess of magic has crafted for you from memory. With ease, the words spill from your lips and you can sense the change that begins to swell emitting from your form, affecting the space all around you. The warmth on your face from the fire grows as it swells and sighs from your very essence. You allow your eyes to squint open as you lift an arm to shield yourself as you peer into the flame. They have changed color, flickering and moving, shifting and changing, taking away the heat and discomfort, transforming as a woman begins to rise from the flame. Immediately, you know that you are peering upon the goddess Ceridwen, the one responsible for bringing you here. She unfurls from the flames like a phoenix as her body begins to shift, taking form. She's powerful and beautiful, radiating uncontrolled, divine, feminine energy. She steps forward, untouched by the flames, her eyes gentle and delighted, brimming with ancient knowledge and wisdom. The deity greets you, her voice reminding you of a favorite blanket or pillow. Everything about the goddess's presence reminds you of a warm hug, the gentle tone of a concerned and loving mother, or even the soft embrace of a comfort meal upon your tongue. Ceridwen's gaze trails from yours to your outstretched hand, your fingers almost white from clutching your focus, the mythical object you had selected earlier. A smile tugs at the corners of her lips as she tells you how you had surprised her in your selection. Her fingertips caress your knuckles and they become limp and relaxed under her touch. The goddess's gaze falls upon the sight of your artifact, outstretched before her within your palm. She lets out a soft hum and slowly tilts her head. She turns away, back towards the now dimmed flames, peering into the cauldron. The explosive, intense broiling has come to a stop, leaving the liquid gently shimmering. The two of you peer into the potion of your creation, and you notice the scent, the color, even the way bubbles rise to the surface. The goddess asks you your intentions when you had created the elixir, urging you to explore what your desires are from this moment. You speak whenever you are ready. Bearing your very essence to the deity before you as she guides you to the answer of what it is that you are seeking and how it manifests within your magic. As your conversation comes to a slow, the goddess reaches above her mantle, plucking an intricate glass vial. It is unique in size and shape, a direct representation of you. Notice its lid, the color of the glass, the way it reflects the dim, low light of the fire. You watch as Ceridwen places the vial within the cauldron. Filling it up with the now cool potion, whether it is simply the first 3 drops or until she is satisfied. The goddess stands up straight, cradling the vial gently within her hand. Rolling it between her fingers, her eyes transfixed until the magical flames begin to rise again, reaching upwards until the now empty cauldron is engulfed. Ceridwen places the vial, the representation of you, the potion of your own craft, upon her mantle. Speaking softly, she explains to you that this is now a direct line to you within her realm. As the words pass her lips, the fire roars in response, growing in size and ferocity. The two of you peer within the magical flames and slowly, steadily, in time with your breathing, a door begins to appear. As it fades into view, you recognize it as the doorway to your bedroom. From the realm where your earthly form rests, the goddess embraces you tightly and suddenly. Any last words flowing from her lips? She reassures you that whatever you seek is well within your grasp. And whatever is for you has already been written. reminding you of the magic within you and how to amplify it, warning you of its power if it is not properly revered. And finally, her fingertips brush along your shoulders, a gentle gesture encouraging you into the flame. You steady yourself, breathing slowly and steadily, knowing that the goddess would never harm you, and to not be afraid of anything within her realm. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. Breathe in and out. With one final glance over your shoulder, you step into the flame, untouched by their heat, as they seem to make way for you. Rising from the flames, you can see the entryway to your bedroom. The door is just as you had remembered it, unscratched by the elements, radiating your own personal magic. And with a gentle touch, you push it open, slowly stepping through this realm, back to the next. You can feel the familiarity of your home, the smells and sounds immediately making you feel safe. Slowly, your celestial form fades into the realm where your earthly form rests. You can see your body resting upon your mattress, eyes closed, your body limp and relaxed. You're breathing soft and steady. You can feel the slow pull of your spirit as it begins to re-merge with your form. To do so, you do your very best to match the breathing of your form. Breathe in and feel your divine self slowly settle back into your skin. Starting with passing back through the portal of your third eye, breathe out. Breathe in, sink back into your body, fully returning to your form. Feeling the warmth of the heat, you naturally create the steady thrumming of your heartbeat. The slow, gentle rising of your lungs with each breath. Breathe in, feel the weight of sleep, the blanket of relaxation the goddess has left upon you. Breathe out. Now, fully returned, calm and relaxed, holding the knowledge that the goddess has given you tightly to your chest, as the swirling of the living portal finally slows, closing your third eye. Your exhausted mind, body, and spirit finally come to a slow until they are still, tranquil and relaxed, allowing you to finally fall asleep.
Thank you. Thank you.